Hey there, my name's Daniel White. Some of you may know me as Dansky, and in this video, we're going to learn how to design a Bauhaus inspired business card, all in Adobe InDesign. And if you'd like to download any of the free fonts that have been brought back to life from the Bauhaus Dessau Foundation, then there is a link in the video description. But anyway, let's jump into it. Rightio, so we're now in InDesign, and the first thing I'm going to do is create a new document. So let's go to File, down to New, and select Document. Now I'm going to create a square business card with a width and height of 57 millimeters. And we've got some other options down here. We can add some margins on the top, bottom, left and right edge. You can set these here, and essentially it just makes it really easy to snap elements on your page to these different margins. And we can also add some bleed. Bleed is always a good idea to add if your design is going to touch the edge of the page. Essentially what it means is if you have a large print run and there are thousands of items being printed, sometimes you get a bit of a shift in paper, there's some movement, and it might be very slight, 1 or 2 mil. Adding some bleed and extending your artwork into the bleed area just compensates for that, and it just means you're not going to get any white edges around the edge of the final design when it's printed and trimmed. So because my artwork, as I say, will touch the edge, I'm going to add 3 millimeters of bleed and click Create. And there we go. So we have the page itself, we have the pink guide marking the 5 mil margin, and then we have our 3 mil of bleed around the edge marked with the red line. Now at the moment this is normal view, and you can toggle between these over here. So I've got normal, and I can switch over to preview, which shows me what my artwork will look like when it's trimmed. So everything outside of the white area is something that will not appear on the final design. What I see within this space is what will be exported. So the first thing I'm going to do actually is just switch over to Illustrator and grab the logo I'm going to be using, the B for Bauhaus, and we'll just copy and paste that into InDesign. It's rather large, so I'm just going to scale that down up here and just shimmy that off to the side. And you can see when I move it out here, it's no longer visible, and I can just toggle back to this normal view here, or use W as the shortcut on the keyboard, and it just allows me to view the pasteboard. So this is quite a good place around the edge to store bits and pieces, images, bits of text, logos, and then when you're ready to use them, you can just drag them into view here and arrange them. So that's pretty handy. So what I'm going to do now is grab the type tool and just left click and drag to create a text box. And we're going to type a name. So we'll type Johnny Smith. There we go. And we can just highlight that. And I've got lots of panels over here on the right and some options along the top. If you don't see any of these panels on the right for whatever reason, just go up to Window. You can see them all here, and then you can drag and drop and arrange these as you like to fully customize your workspace. So I've got the paragraph panel here. So I can then centrally align this text. And then from the character panel, I can also adjust some font options, or I can do this from the top of the screen here. So it depends entirely on how you've got your workspace set up. I'm going to be using the font Kalmar Regular. So let's select that. And I can drag this into position. So we've got the name of the person, and this is a business card. So we will need to include a job title as well. And he is, of course, going to be a designer. And we're also going to have some contact information at the bottom as well. So what we can do is we can go to Edit, Copy, and then we could go Edit, Paste in Place again. But a quicker way of duplicating this is by holding the Alt key to create a copy. And if you hold Shift as well, it will drag it horizontally or vertically. That's a really quick way to create copies of an object. Okay, so now we can, of course, type a fictional phone number. There we go. And I'm just going to enter an email. And you can see here, I've kind of reached the edge of the text box. So if I continue to type a web address, it isn't actually visible, and we get this little red box with a cross in here. And essentially what that's telling me is, hey, there's some more text in here, but you're not seeing it because the text box is too small. So we can just extend the text box either down or to the sides, and then it just reveals that text. So now again, we can use the type tool to select all of the text, and we can adjust the size up here at the top of the screen or from the character panel or paragraph panel on the right.
So let's go for something like this, and we can close that text box. There we go. And I think I'm going to have the name and the job title all in uppercase. So we can select that here, and we can go to type, change case. Or what you can do is you've got some quick shortcuts here. So we have the all caps option. So I can just click that and it automatically capitalizes all of the letters. We can also adjust the leading, also known as line height here as well. So I can just bring these two lines a little bit closer together. And then we need to try and integrate the logo. So you can see we've got some smart guides here, really helpfully lining this up to the center. And we can just scale this down and maybe snap that up to the top edge. And we could do something like that, which is very functional. It shows the contact information and shows the logo nice and clearly. But I think because this is a Bauhaus inspired design, we're going to get a bit more creative. So what I'm going to do is just drag the logo out to the pasteboard. And I'm actually going to use the direct selection tool and just left click, hold shift, and then left click on both of these bottom two anchor points and then hit delete or backspace on the keyboard. And what it does is remove those points and leave me with the B from the Bauhaus, just with that box removed. And I can then drag over these other two remaining points and hit delete or backspace on those. And then just drag over these top two anchor points with the direct selection tool and go to object, down to path, and select join. And it just completes that path. It doesn't look like anything happens there, but it just joins those two anchor points together. And I've now got this as a shape within InDesign. So I've taken it out of the box, and there is a very good reason for that. So I'm going to grab the rectangle tool, and we're going to get a bit creative now. So I've just drawn a rectangle, and from the swatches panel, we've got lots of swatches. We get some in here by default, and when I copy and pasted the logo, it was using a particular shade of yellow. We've got that here, and it automatically imports that swatch. So we can click on this swatch, and we can actually double click on this as well. And we can go name with color value. Now, this is an RGB color that I've used. And when we're doing design for print, you can only use cmyk, which stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Those are the four inks in a full color print, unless you're printing with Pantone colors, but that's a whole different conversation. So let's assume that we're just doing a full color cmyk print for this video. So we're going to want to change this from RGB to CMYK. There we go. And you can see the percentages, they have a decimal place in them. We don't want that because you can't print with decimal places. We need to round this up. So let's go 0, 16, and 84. So there we go. This will work for CMYK printing. So we can now click OK. And you can see here it displays those values. So we have our rectangle, and what I'm going to do is actually rotate this. So with the rotate tool, the shortcut for that is R on the keyboard. I'm just going to rotate, and I can hold shift, and it will snap to a 45 degree angle. And if I just move the B out of the way, I think what I'm actually going to do is get a little bit more creative. So if I extend this down here, so that this touches the edge. Now you can extend this out from the side, or you can hold the Alt key on your keyboard and it will extend from both sides of the shape. And I'm going to bring this out over the bleed there, just because this yellow rectangle does touch the edge of the page, so I'm going to extend that well into the bleed area. And I'm going to bring the logo back in. I think I'm going to change the logo color to white. And of course, you can't see the logo at the moment because it's behind, but we can go to Object, Arrange, Bring to Front. And again, just use that Rotate tool and hold Shift to snap that to the same 45 degree angle. And then I'm just going to bring this up in size as well. And just make sure that this is central. Now, you can use the arrow keys to move this around, or you can use the mouse. It's entirely up to you. So you can use those to position it. And then I'm going to bring the text back in. Of course, that's all behind as well. So I'm actually just going to select the yellow rectangle, go to Object, Arrange, and send that to the back instead. Then I can select all of the text and use that Rotate tool and Shift to rotate that so it snaps to the 45 degree angle. Then we'll put the text down here. And we'll just make sure to select the text with the Type tool before changing any colors. And we'll change this to white. If you don't use the Type tool to select the text and you just click on the box and then start adding colors, you'll see it does this, which isn't quite what we want. And I'm actually just going to select this text as well. This is going to be a lot smaller. And I'm going to bring this up. So you can see I'm making lots of slight adjustments here, just to try and fit everything together so that the composition works. And I'm actually going to create another yellow rectangle and position this down here, rotate 45 degrees. So I'm definitely making this challenging for myself because as I'm designing this, I'm designing it all on an angle. So when the business card is printed, it will essentially be held upright in a diamond shape. So I'm kind of designing it on a bit of an angle. But if you tilt your head 45 degrees to the side, you'll see what I'm going for. And we do actually have a pencil here as well. So we've got the nib of the pencil, the main body of the pencil here. So I'm just trying to be a bit clever, a bit creative. Make this logo a bit bigger. We've got lots of space here. And we can just do this as well, so I can increase the size here. Now you can increase the size by selecting the text and using the font size and adjusting the leading here, or you can just use the main selection tool and you can increase this text box as you would with any other object. Now of course you will get font sizes like 15.234, but if you're just being creative and you're really just trying to get the concept nailed down, this is quite a good way of increasing or decreasing the size of some text, and it retains all of the proportions for things like leading and spacing and all that good stuff. And there we go. We've designed a Bauhaus inspired business card all in Adobe InDesign.